Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about Angular Interceptor and how we can use Angular Interceptor to mock the API response. So if you will see, this is the Angular front end, and this front end is communicating to my backend services, that is Spring Boot RESTful services. And we are not going to discuss much about Spring Boot, but if you will see, my front end is calling this service. And this is fetching data from MongoDB, and the service is returning data to my front-end application as a JSON format, JSON response, and we are displaying it. So basically, when we worked in the enterprise applications, so there is a chance that our API is developed. API development takes time to complete it, and since we have to work with the backend team parallelly, so to do that, we have to mock the response, and then we have to work. We have to continue the work for the front end. So if you will see here, like it's a very very simple services, but in the enterprise application they take a lot of time. So what we are going to do, this part we are going to display as a mock response using Interceptor. So you know this is service, so this is HTTP service. So every HTTP service will pass through the HTTP interceptor. So the idea is, so this is my one interceptor, my interceptor that implement HTTP interceptor. So idea is, rather than returning the actual response, we will create a one. Like we will read the API type, what is the type of API, like my API contains includes all employee, and I will create a mock response using new HTTP response, and I have two parameter in that, status and body. Body contains the response of the API. So I am returning this as a array. Okay, it is similar what is actual API will return, the only the data will get change. So before that, if you will see, the type of the return response should be in the observable format. So we are going to return this response with off. So this off operator is a RxJS operator, so it will convert this response in an observable format. So if you will see, we are not going to return here the response, we are going to return the mock response. Once it will match, if I will save it and if I will refresh my application, you can see now we are not calling a API, and we are able to see the response from the mock response. So this is our idea, and let us discuss little bit about Angular Interceptor. Type HTTP interceptor here. It will give us an option like HTTP interceptor, and then we can click on it, and then we can see all the information of HTTP interceptor here. So here, as we can see, it is an interface HTTP interceptor, and it has one intercept method that accept argument request and next. So the request is HTTP request, and it can be any type based on our request. So my request, if you will see, my request, let me show it first. I have to disable this. So my request is nothing since it's the get call. So request contains in a post call. So it is just returning all employee based on this my all employee flag in my controller. So let me again enable it. So what we were discussing, let us go here. So basically, request, when we have some structure of our request, so we can create a structure and we can pass instead of any. And the next is, it is useful if we have multiple interceptor. So suppose my first interceptor is my interceptor. It is just one simple name. So in enterprise application, we can have logger interceptor, we can have error interceptor. So once we have this next, and if you will see in my code, I am calling next.handle to pass this the same request. So I am just cloning this, but actually what happens, like in first interceptor, we can handle the headers, we can update the headers. In second interceptor, we can handle the logging. So it will pass this handle to the next interceptor, and that will start executing in the same manner. So this is the idea behind it. So let us read more about this. And it returns observable of HTTP events. If you will see in the description, most interceptor transform the outgoing request before passing to the next interceptor in the chain. So the first interceptor can transform the request, means we can add the headers. Now this headers will be available in the second interceptor. And by calling next.handle, we can pass transform request. An interceptor may transform response event as well, response event stream as well, by applying additional RxJS operator on the stream returned by next.handle. We can convert our response also in the interceptor itself, but we will discuss this later, not in this video. More rarely, an interceptor may handle request entirely and compose a new event stream instead of invoking. So instead of invoking next.handle, we can even create our own response. So you can see, if I will remove this, it will should work. Oh, it's not working. Means, oh, I have to enable this code also, right? Because we are returning the response from here. So if you will see, still it is not working, but for that we having this if condition, so it may return or it may not return. So if you will put else, and if you will put this here, so it is 100% we are going to return this, right? Something, one of the block will execute and it will always return the response that will be in the observable format, right? So you can see the error is gone away. So there is not necessarily that we have to include this next.handle with HTTP request. But what will happen if you will not include this, means your further interceptor will not going to execute, will be skipped entirely. Okay, so I think we have discussed all the thing about this mock the response in this video, how to mock the response. So let us little bit discuss. So quickly, if you will see, this is my interceptor and it's implement HTTP interceptor, and it has interceptor method, and it takes HTTP request and HTTP sorry, next as a two argument. It is a HTTP handler, and it returns observable of HTTP events, and that is type any. So this is request any, this is response any. We can have two request and response agent model, and then we can pass it here. If you will see this HTTP clone, we are cloning the request. We are not doing anything, we are just cloning it. We haven't modified anything in the request, since we just want to mock the response. And whenever my request URL contains app employee, we are going to return the mock response from here. And we are not worry about next.handle call in that case. Okay, so this is the idea behind it. And if you will see how to register this my interceptor, we have to provide HTTP interceptor. Comes from Angular common HTTP, and we have to use class my interceptor. And the multi true means it's a multi provider. It's a multi provider means interceptor can have multiple, we can have multiple interceptor, so we have to pass multi true. Okay friends, I think we have done all the thing regarding how to mock the response, and we have discussed all the thing. So hope this will help you.